everyone, and I am so glad that you are joining us today online, and I am so excited to be with you. You know, all summer long, we have been discovering confidence, and not just confidence that you can find everywhere, but the confidence to see yourself the way that God sees you. We have been discovering things all summer long, and we are going to continue it through the month of July. But before we can get started today, I need you to share this with your friends. Share it with those that you haven't seen all summer long at school. Share it with your cousins. Share it with your neighbors. And let's share confidence with all of those around us. Okay, now that you have done that, let's stand up and let's get ready for worship.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. Now your mercy has saved my soul.
know the reason why my feet can't stop, my heart can't help but sing. It's a wonderful feeling to feel your love for me, to feel the joy you bring. Your love is the answer, so I sing to you. The reason is you, Jesus.
You're why I'm singing out.
The reason is you, Jesus.
You're what it's all about.
The cross, you set me free, and I'm thankful that you love me. Whoa, oh, 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 oh. I'm thankful that you love me. Whoa, oh, 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 oh. I know the reason why my hands are up, my feet dance down below. It's a wonderful feeling that I belong. So I sing to you. The reason is you, Jesus.
You're why I'm singing out.
The reason is you, Jesus.
You're what it's all about.
At the cross you set me free, and I'm thankful that you love me. Whoa. You're the reason I never want to shake this feeling. Jesus, you're the reason.
I can't stop this feeling. Jesus, you're the reason. I never want to shake this feeling. Jesus, you're the
Mic check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Press play.
Jesus, we know we belong here because of your love for us that goes on and on forever. Jesus, we know you are with us wherever we go. You're there, we'll always be together.
So sing along with me for all the joy he brings.
It's going down. Get in the mix.
We're not stopping.
Get in the mix.
The party's hopping.
Get in the mix.
Everybody say,
we know we belong here because of your love for us that goes on and on forever. Jesus, we know you are with us wherever we go. You're there, we'll always be together.
So sing along with me for all the joy he brings.
It's going down. Get in the mix.
We're not stopping.
Get in the mix.
The party's everybody say, it's time to press play.
Get in the mix.
The beat is dropping.
Get in the mix.
Feet are stomping.
Get in the mix.
Everybody say,
like this. Have confidence to get in the mix. Clap your hands like this. Have confidence to get in the mix. Now clap your hands like this.
Like this.
Have confidence to get in the mix. Now clap your hands like this.
Like this.
Everybody get in the mix.
Get in the mix.
We're not stopping.
Get in the mix.
The party's stopping.
Get in the mix.
Everybody say.
Hey everybody, I'm Graham. I've always had the dream of becoming a professional singer.
The wheels on the bus go round and round all through the town.
I'm kind of afraid to perform in front of other people, but lately I've been starting to gain confidence. Confidence is learning to see yourself the way God sees you. I think it might help if I didn't have to perform all alone. Like, maybe if I was in a band with a guitar player? And someone on the drums? And maybe a keyboardist? I think a band is the way to go for me. I wonder how we would all sound together. 2, 3, 4!
The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish all through the...
Well, despite how that sounded, I actually did feel more confident. So I guess what they say is true. There is strength in numbers. Or there's confidence in numbers. With a band, you never feel like you're alone. In today's story, we'll hear about three guys who were in a really hot situation, but they didn't have to face it alone. I wonder if my band needs a brass section. No, probably not. See you soon.
This is the so-and-so show. Normally my co-host John would be here, but today I guess he decided to... What is going on?
Brandon, would you like some coffee? Whoa, how is that coffee mug floating? It's crazy, right?
It's definitely crazy.
Ooh, Brandon, I know that you're freaked out because you can't see me, but don't be. Just keep doing the show, like I'm here, standing beside you.
Okay. Anyway.
Because I am.
Is there a point to all this?
Isn't there always a point to what I do?
Almost never.
The point is, Brandon, you rely on me way too much to do this show. And I want you to feel like you have the confidence to do this show when I'm not around. That's why I'm wearing this green screen, to make myself invisible.
Okay. I think that only works when you're on a green screen.
Oh, no, Brandon! Whoa, the coffee mug's floating around. Better get one more sip of Java. Wow!
One anymore. Anyway, today we're talking about confidence.
Look at the cube floating. This magnificent geometrical shape is solving itself. Whoa.
It's already solved. Anyway, we're talking about confidence, and we're trying to learn.
I'm super chicken. Look at me, I'm super chicken.
We're trying to learn how to see ourselves the way God sees us.
See ourselves, see me. Oh, how did my head just show up? How did my head just show up? Oh, no, it's blocking you.
Mm, yeah.
It's floating.
Say, I thought I was trying to learn how to do the show by myself.
Say no more.
Okay.
Give me a second.
Wish it worked.
Yeah, hold on.
All right.
With my zippers down my shirt.
Oh, boy.
Shh. Here we go. Okay, go.
Thank you. Today on the show, we're talking about
confidence. I'm sorry. I can't do it, man. I thought I could just stand here silently doing nothing, but you know what? I can't do that to you, pal. I just can't. Let's play a game.
Okay, but what kind of game could we possibly play when I can't even see you?
Oh, right. A simple one, mayhaps? For instance, how many fingers am I holding up?
How many fingers am I holding up?
Ready?
Three. You're holding up three fingers.
How about now?
One.
How about now?
Four. Six. Zero.
Okay! This is too easy. Let's play a different game. Let's play Marco Polo!
Marco Polo!
You know how to play Marco Polo. You will say Marco, and I will say Polo. Then you'll have to locate me just by the sound of my voice! Ooh, 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 ready?
Marco!
Polo.
You're right there.
What?
By the chair.
I don't understand why this is... Okay, you know what? Let's play one more game.
We don't need to keep doing this. I can see you.
What? I'm invisible! If I'm not invisible, what's the point of me coming out here wearing this spandex suit?
I don't know. Silly sight gag?
I don't do silly sight gags. I'm serious, man.
Dodgeball!
Are you sure about this? No? Are you sure about this, John?
You can't hit me. I'm invisible. Oh. Ooh.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Could have been a lot worse.
How's that?
Oh, that.
It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Oh.
What's up, fellas?
Tell him, I'm invisible.
Sorry, he might be concussed. What are we talking about today, Kellen?
Today's story is about three guys who went through something terrifying, but...
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
What?
Three ordinary men who had the confidence to stand up for what they believed.
What is happening right now?
We'll hear their story today on Behind the Bible. The Babylonian king, Nebuchadnezzar, ordered the construction of a golden 90-foot-tall statue.
Oh, yeah. I love that statue. I remember thinking one day, I wonder if I could get a 90-foot gold statue made. And my officials was like, sure. I mean, let me tell you, it's good to be the king.
Okay, to be clear, King Nebuchadnezzar never gave any on-camera interviews. He lived hundreds of years ago before cameras were even invented.
Hey.
Yes?
This will go a lot faster if you let me do the narrating.
Okay.
Thank you. Nebuchadnezzar decreed that whenever the music was played, everyone must fall down and worship his statue. Anyone who disobeyed this command would be thrown into a blazing furnace.
Okay, look, it seemed like a good idea at the time. I mean, what's a little worship between a king and his subjects? But how could I have known what was gonna happen next?
No one could have known what would happen next. When the music played, all the people worshiped the statue. all except for three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
It's true. We didn't bow down to worship the statue. Look, we serve the king, but we don't worship him or his gods. We worship the one true God.
King Nebuchadnezzar was displeased.
Okay, listen. No king likes to be told no. So when I heard these three wouldn't worship my statue, I was angry. I remember saying to them,
if you don't bow down right now, you're going in the furnace. Then what God will be able to save you from my power?
Yeah, I was in a good place.
Look, we weren't gonna worship the statue, no matter what. So we said to the king, we might be thrown into the blazing furnace, but the God that we serve is able to bring us out of it alive. We want you to know this, Your Majesty. Even if we knew that our God wouldn't save us, we still wouldn't serve your gods. We wouldn't worship the gold statue that you set up.
I was so mad. Like, so mad. I ordered that the furnace be heated 7 times hotter than normal. And then I had some of my strongest soldiers to tie up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and throw them into the furnace.
The fire was so hot, the soldiers who threw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the furnace were burned up.
But that wasn't the end of the story.
It sure wasn't.
King Nebuchadnezzar looked into the furnace, and instead of seeing the three tied up men, he saw 4 men, and they were walking around. Who was the 4th man in the furnace? Was it a ghost? An angel sent from heaven? Maybe even Jesus himself? We don't know for sure. But what we do know is that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the fire unharmed.
The ropes that were tied around us, they burned up. But the rest of us, our clothes, our hair, our bodies, they were perfectly fine. God was with us the whole time.
Clearly, I was wrong about the whole statue thing. I mean, their God was the Most High God. So I gave Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego very high positions in the city. And get this, I decreed that anyone who said anything bad about them would be cut into tiny little pieces and their homes would be turned into piles of trash. Right? That's good, right?
That was a little much, but we appreciate the gesture.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego's faith was tested. But in the end, they had confidence that God would be with them, no matter what. This has been Behind the Bible.
The end.
Excuse me, that's my line.
Oh.
The end.
Can I?
Oh, sure. It's all yours.
Thanks. What'd you think, fellas?
That was great.
Yeah, I loved how they said that they knew God would save them, but even if he didn't, they'd still stand for what's right.
Yeah, talk about confidence.
Mm-hmm.
I know, but don't miss this. God was with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego the whole time. And God is with us too, so we don't have to face the hard stuff alone.
That's amazing. Hey, thanks, Kellen.
You bet. See you next time.
Bye. You see, John, when you're not around, I'm still not alone. God is always with me.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Well, in that case...
Yeah. I don't ever want to get my lips and my hair cut in the zipper.
Okay.
It's all you!
Oh boy. Reveal the question! When are some times you need to trust God?
When you feel all alone?
Or when you have to face something scary, like moving to a new city or trying out for a sports team.
Talk about it amongst yourself. When are some times you need to trust God?
And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show.
Oh, will you be able to see me?
Yes. Marco?
Polo!
John?
Yeah.
Oh, hey, there you are.
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't find you because you're wearing the green screen suit.
Okay. You okay?
Yeah, tag. I don't know. Sorry, you're it.
Okay. Marco.
Oh, hello.
Oh, you're right there.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had a ton of confidence, didn't they? They stood for what was right even when they knew what was at stake. And they stood together. All three were thrown into the fiery furnace, and miraculously, they weren't alone. God was in there with them the whole time. That's how it is with us, too. God is always with us. In fact, after Jesus died and came back to life, one of the last things he said to his disciples was this: "You can be sure that I am always with you to the very end." So that means when you have to do something scary, God is with you. When you feel like you're too tired to move, God is with you. When you need strength, God is with you. And when you're with a band of friends who know you and care about you, God is also there with you. God loves you so much, and he won't let you face this life alone. So here's the one thing to remember today. Trust that God is always with you. Remind yourself when you're feeling less than confident that you are never alone. Well, I should probably get in some practice with my band. Didn't sound very good earlier. I think we need a little Band-Aid. Get it? Band-Aid? I'll see you next time.
Dear God, I've been doing my drills. I've been working out. I've been playing in the neighborhood as much as I can. But all the magazines still say that you have to be at least 6 feet tall. Dad isn't tall, neither is Mom. So I started doing what I could. But nothing really worked. I thought there might be no use. I just wasn't gonna be a basketball player. That's when Mom came in the room. She said, maybe I should read something else. And then she took all my magazines. I couldn't believe it. Thought it was gonna be some kind of weird punishment. But she said she had a present for me. At first, just looking at it, it was, I don't know, just a poster on the wall. Then I started to think about it. Then I started to think about it when I played. And God, it makes sense. You made me. You love me. My job is to keep playing as hard as I can. Thanks, God. Justin.
Isn't it amazing to know that God is always with you? You can trust God to know that he will always be with you no matter what. When you're at school, when you're at the park, or when you're somewhere that you're a little bit scared to go, like maybe the doctor or the dentist. Just like in our story today of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they stood up for what they believed in, and they believed in God, and they wouldn't let anyone else tell them different. And because they did that, they knew that God would always be with them. So when you go to school this school year, you can stand up for God and know that God is with you and trust to know that he will never leave you. I hope you guys enjoyed today. Have fun celebrating the 4th with your family, and we will see you guys next time.